Hi, I'm Helle, and today we'll take a quick look at the Danish game called Plingo. This is a party game for 4 to 8 players, and I don't think you can get the game in other countries than in Denmark. But in this game, you have a lot of cards with words on. There are words on two sides, and here we have bacon, which is also an English word, and you have a lot of different words written on these cards. This way you can write down words, and there are 8 of them, and there are 8 pencils, and you have these points and a little bell. And we have an hourglass. In this game, it's all about giving clues to the player that is in turn. There are 2 phases in the game. One where players, they will write down clue words, or they are called stealing words, because you want to steal the turn from another player that is giving clues to the player in turn. So if I was in turn, I would draw a card. And all other players except me would get to see what was on this card, and the word on the card. And when everyone has seen it, then it's time for everyone to write down clue words, what they associate with this word. It is words you will think another player will use when they have to try to explain the word for me that doesn't know what the word is. So all players, they will write down up to 7, and when we play the game, we always draw a line here so we can use it twice, because you are going to lose a lot of these papers in the game. And when the first player has written down 7 words, then they will ring the bell. And every player has to stop writing. They can finish the word they are writing, but you have to stop writing further words. So some might have 3, 4, or 5, or also 7 words written down. This was the first phase. The next phase is the guessing phase. And if I was the player in turn, then the player to my left will give me clues. And we have 1 minute for me to guess the word. So we will start the timer, and the person on my left will start giving me clue words, and they can only say a single word. You may not make sentences, and you may not say any words that is included in this word. If the person can get me to guess the word, then I can say the word, and he will say yes or no if it's correct or not. If, however, the person mentions a word that another player has written down, then they are allowed to ring the bell, and they will take the turn and try to get me to guess the word. So, and if more people have written the same word down, then the first player to ring the bell will be in turn. Now, what can happen next is, if we run out of time and I haven't guessed the word, then all other players but me and the player in turn to give me clues, they will receive 1 point. If I manage to guess the word, then I and the player who is giving clues at the moment, we will both receive 2 points. If the player in turn mentions anything, if he accidentally said bacon or something else that was included, if you had Water World and the person said water, then we, all other players except the player that mentioned a word that was written here, will receive 1 point. And I would get to draw a new one, and we will start a new round, still where I was in turn. So in this game, when you have to give clues to the person that has to guess the word, then you have to think of words that you don't think others they have written down, but still will be words that can help the player in turn to guess what the word is. And this game is played over several rounds, and you can decide how many rounds you want to play, if you want to play 2, 3, or 4 rounds of the game. And this game is pretty stressful, because you are always, you have to write down words, you are under pressure of the time, getting to give good clues and maybe take the turn if you have written down a clue, so you can now start giving clues. So it's a stressful game, kind of like time. You're under time pressure, and you're under pressure when you have to think quick. You have to be creative when you play this game. And both Lena and I, we enjoyed this little game, and it's pretty fairly simple, but I think a lot of people can play this game. But it's not one that I would play 3 or 4 times in a row, because it's really mind-draining, this game, because you are so much on and you have to think when you play the game. So you want something where you can relax a bit after you have played the game a couple of times. So that is pretty much Plingo, a Danish party game. And I just wanted to give you a look into what the game is all about, because Lina and I have made a Danish video of the game. And if you were wondering, what is this? You were curious, then here you go. That was it for me. Thanks for watching. Bye.